Hey guys, a very good morning to all of you. I hope that you are preparing hard for your examination. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs, and I have brought this video only to boost your preparation for the upcoming RBI, SEBI and NABARD examinations. So let's quickly begin with this video, and I hope that during the course of this video you learn something new. And if you learn, then do not forget to subscribe our channel. And guys, the PDF of this session will be provided to you on our Telegram channel, and you can join the channel via the link given below in the description below. Okay, so that was all about the introduction part. Now let's begin with our first question. So which state became the first beneficiary of iDrone model of ICMR? Manipur, Nagaland, Tripura, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh. So out of these, Manipur is the right answer. Now what is this iDrone model? Now guys, before moving into the details, let me give you a brief introduction of this model. So basically, iDrone model is the initiative developed by ICMR in order to deliver the vaccines of COVID-19 virus, or we can say pandemic, to the remotest areas by using the drones. That is the whole crux of this iDrone model, delivering vaccines via drones to the remotest and hilly areas. And in towards that initiative, Manipur became the first beneficiary of this initiative. Now let's go into the details of this. Okay, so this is for the very first time that the vaccines have been delivered, the COVID vaccines have been delivered via drones by the government agency. Guys, can you tell me that which state is doing this for a long period of time? We can say for 1 year, because that state started delivering medicines via drones back in the year 2019. So can you tell us the name of the state in the comment section below? Moving back to this question or this news, so it is for the first time that the central government has used the drones to deliver the COVID-19 vaccines, and that too in the state of Manipur. Now do remember that at present only Manipur, Nagaland and Andaman and Nicobar have got the permission to use drones to deliver the vaccine. Now the full name of this iDrone system is ICMR's Drone Response and Outreach in the Northeast. So here you can see that the focus is on the northeastern region and not pan India. Okay, so do pay attention to the full form as well, and this is all about this initiative. And do remember that the drone that was used to deliver medicines in Manipur was indigenously made. Okay, so that was all. Now let's move on to the next question, which is going to be a very interesting question for you. Where is India's first vertical lift railway sea bridge being developed? So Thanjavur, Munnar, Pamban, Vellore, Badami. So these are the five options. Right out of these options, the right answer is Pamban. So Pamban Sea Bridge or Pamban Railway Bridge is being reconstructed, and after reconstruction it will look like this. So I'm going to show you the bridge for your better understanding. Okay, so let's have a look. So guys, this bridge is going to join two places, Mandapam and Rameshwaram. I'm going to discuss that as well, but just have a look at this. This is going to be the marvelous technology, and it will be India's first vertical lift railway sea bridge. As you can see that the bridge is being uplifted. And this, my friends, is the old bridge, which is already there in place, and look how it is opening. So it is opening horizontally, whereas this vertical bridge will be lifting upwards. Okay, now you don't have to memorize these details. Okay, just look at the mechanism, and I showed you this video so that you can get an idea, and it makes it easier for you to understand how this vertical lift bridges work and what is new about it, that it becomes the first ever vertical lift sea bridge in India. So that was all. I hope that now you have understood what is the functioning of this sea bridge. Now let's go into the details. So as I have told you that it is going to connect Rameshwaram with Mandapam, and you already have seen this in the video as well. Now it will be operational from March next year, and it is India's first vertical lift railway bridge. The new Pamban bridge is being developed by Railway Vikas Nigam Limited. So that is all that you need to memorize from your exam point of view. Particularly, we are catering to the phase one of RBI SEBI NABARD. Therefore, you don't have to go into the too much of its detail as it was shown in the video. The video's purpose was to show you how is it going to work. And as I always say that pictures, videos, audios always help you in memorizing things better. So this is how you can also create your own notes. You can also arouse your curiosity and learn more about certain news. Okay. Now let's move on to the next question. So who heads IFCA expert panel on sustainable finance hub? So out of these options, the right answer is CK Mishra. Now, what is the purpose of the sustainable finance hub? Basically, within IFSCA, that is International Financial Services Center, which is in the GIFT City in Gandhinagar, this panel will recommend how they can create a hub wherein sustainable finance is flourishing, wherein the companies are financing the projects that are sustainable in nature, environment friendly nature. So basically, sustainable finance, I have explained a lot of times earlier as well, it is nothing but the financing to the renewable energy projects and the environmental friendly projects that are sustainable in nature. Okay, so that is all about this news. Now do remember, it is a 10 member group. Can you tell me that who is the head of the longevity finance hub of IFSCA? This is your question for the day. Do tell me in the comment section below. Moving on to the next question, and this question requires explanation. This is a very interesting question, I must say. Okay, in which of the following country is India not mentoring the capacity building program under the Tax Inspectors Without Borders initiative? So you must have read about it when India became the partner administration in Bhutan for the same initiative. What is this initiative all about? That we will be discussing for short. But let's first answer this question. Seychelles, Estwini, Uganda, Sierra Leone. Out of these options, the right answer is Chile. So India is the partner administration for basically under this program in all of these countries except for Chile. Okay, so now let's discuss this initiative. First of all, this initiative has been launched in Seychelles right now. That's why it is in the news, and India has been chosen as the partner administration for Seychelles. Now, what is the meaning of partner administration, or what is the whole purpose of this initiative? The basic purpose is to strengthen the auditing ecosystem in the other country, in the developing country. Okay, so India has been chosen as the partner administration. That means that India will be leading the mentoring program, the capacity building program in Seychelles and the other countries in which India is acting as the partner administration under this program. Okay, so I hope that it is comprehensive to you. Now, this program will be for 12 months, and the focus, particularly in the context of Seychelles, will be on transfer pricing cases of tourism and financial services sectors. So these will be the focus areas. Now, the Secretariat of Tax Inspectors Without Borders initiative, which is located in Paris. So the Secretariat, UNDP, Country Office in Mauritius and Seychelles, both of these will be collaborating with Indian experts, which will be training the Seychelles officials. Okay. Now, India is the partner administration in all these countries: Estonia, Sierra Leone, Uganda, Bhutan and Seychelles. So India is at present working in 5 countries under this Tax Inspectors Without Borders initiative. Now I have told you the purpose of this initiative. Now you need to understand that this initiative was launched by UNDP in partnership with OECD in order to strengthen the auditing and tax collection ecosystem across the world. and it was launched in the year 2015. Okay, so 2015 is the year. Now the basic purpose was to strengthen auditing ecosystem, MNC compliance, okay, multinational companies compliance, capacity building of tax officials in the developing countries. Okay, the headquarters is in Paris, as I have already told you. Moving on to the next question, when did Outer Space Treaty come into effect? So here we have been given the dates. The right date is 10th October 1967. You would be thinking that do we have to go into this much detail? Guys, if the date has something important, even today we are celebrating that date, then obviously you have to memorize that date as well. Now, what is the special day on this date? Basically, it marks the end of World Space Week. Okay, so let's go into the details of World Space Week. So this is celebrated from October 4 to 10. And the theme for this year is Women in Space, which was announced last year only. And I had discussed it with you. I hope that you remember the theme. Now on October 4, Soviet Union launched its first, or basically the first ever spacecraft into the space successfully. Sputnik first in 1957. Therefore, October 4 is the marking of this World Space Week, which ends on October 10, which is the date of adoption of Outer Space Treaty. Okay, so do remember the year as well. Now, this Space for Women is the initiative of United Nations in order to increase the involvement of women in space explorations as well as in the STEM careers. Okay, so this is additional information that you need to know. Which country does Nobel laureate Klaus Hasselmann belong to? Czech Republic, Ukraine, Germany, Sweden, Netherlands. Germany is the right answer. Now, Nobel Prize in physics has been announced. We will be discussing that. But let's have a look at the next question as well, because this is also from the Nobels. So in which category has Giorgio Parisi won the Nobel Prize? Physics, chemistry, medicine, economics, literature. The right answer is physics. Okay, so this person has won the award in physics, and as you can see that these are the categories of Nobel Prize plus Peace Prize. But can you tell me that which of these award is given from Oslo? Okay, Oslo is the capital of Norway. One of these awards is given from this Oslo, and the other awards are given from Stockholm. So you have to tell me that which award is this, which category award is given from Oslo. Okay, now let's discuss the Nobel Prize in physics. So it has been awarded to Tsukuro Manabe, who is a Japanese scientist or physicist, we can say, Klaus Hasselmann from Germany, Giorgio Parisi for Italy. Now, Tsukuro Manabe and Klaus, both of them have worked on the same project, or basically for the same cause, they both have got the award. That is their physical modeling of Earth's climate, quantifying variability and reliably predicting global warming. That is the project or the work for which both of these have got this Nobel Prize. But Parisi has got this award for a different reason. And his discovery was the interplay of disorder and fluctuations in physical systems from atomic to planetary scales. Again, this is too much of a science thing. We don't have to go into the details of it, okay? So this is the reason for which Parisi got the award, and this is the reason for which Hasselmann and Manabe got the award. Okay, so that is all about the Nobel Prizes in physics and our today's video. Thank you so much guys for watching the video. I hope that you have learned something new, and if you have, then do subscribe the channel and do not forget to get the PDF of this session. Thank you.